Today's class we will see about pronunciation, page number 111, fricative. With respect to the pronunciation, it's a type of consonant sound which you have learned with respect to phonetics, the way we spell and write, feather, graph, hefty, how you use IPA symbols and you write. This we had seen in the class. It is not something new to you. This has started for you from the beginning of first year. So this may come for 1 mark. Next is grammar. With respect to adjective, you know what is adjective? Something which describes about a noun or a pronoun. Adjectives or qualities are mostly there for us in the syllabus. Adjectives are quality or feelings which state about the origin, size, shape, color, feeling. It is made up of judgment or values, right? It can come before a noun. Samita is a voracious reader. What type of reader is she? She is a voracious. Those who read constantly. After the B sound coming after this can also be a part. Like the movie was fabulous. Fabulous is the adjective over here. She appears dull in the dress. How she appears? She appears beautiful, splendid. Here, dull. Like this. Some adjectives can be without nouns also. The homeless need our help. Such things. Like we have to choose. They will give us 3 words. With respect to size, shape, color or quality, we have to select them in order. Choose the right order of adjectives from the given options. All the given options are adjectives. Jitendra lives in the dash house down the street. The options given here are A. Pink, new, big. B. Big, new, pink. C. New, big, pink. Answer is big, new, pink. Jitendra lives in the big, new, pink house down the street. Like this, we have to select all our adjectives. All are correct, but still in the right order. The Sunday market offers all kinds of dash objects. Fascinating, old, antique. We have to select and write the correct option over there. If they asked us to write the answer, we have to write the option A full answer. Or else we can just keep A. It's always better to write number 1, A and then the full answer. Present and past participle of verbs. We know what are participles, what are present. Ending with ed, ending with ing. Past ends with ed and present ends with ing. Sentence. Fill in the blanks with adjectives formed using the present and past participle of the verbs in brackets. It was a dash book. I was dashed by the book. In the brackets we have bored. It was a boring book and I was bored by the book. We are having past and present together. So ed and ing both are coming over here. The film is dash, full stop. I was dashed while watching it. In the brackets we have frightened. The film is frightening. I was frightened while watching it. Next, I am dash because I have had a dash day. I am tired because I had a tiring day. So based on the spelling, we have to write them past ed, present ing. Next, adjectives or qualities. Choose the appropriate word as adjective from the options provided. There isn't dash sugar in the pot. The options given are much and many. There isn't much sugar in the pot. Many sugar, no one will sit and count 1, 2, 3 like the sugar droplets. So, it is much sugar. Rohan brought dash food with him. Some, many. Here also we have read some. Some food, little bit of food we will save. Not many. Adjectives, comparative, superlative degrees. Like good, better, best. Bad, worse, worst. We see them with respect to positive, comparative and superlative. The same way we are writing over here. Fill in the blanks with the adjectives formed from the words given in the brackets. This is the dash story I have ever read. Fascination is given in the brackets. This is the fascinating story I have ever read. You can't add ed over here. So based on the sentence, you have to see the tense and go on. Non-smokers usually live dash than smokers. Long. Long, longer, longest. More than longest, longer suits over here. So based on the word which is given in the bracket, based on the tense, we have to write the answer. My bungalow is dash than hers. My bungalow is the dash in the corner. Large. comparison. My bungalow is larger than hers. Large, larger, largest. Here, first one is comparison. My bungalow is a dash in the colony. She is comparing the whole colony, so it becomes the largest. Next, when you see the vocabulary, oxymoron and hyperbole. Oxymoron is a figure of speech that juxtaposes elements and appear to be contradictory. Like it may have opposite in meaning. She let out a quiet scream. Screaming itself is saying something louder. Our voice is increased when we see a snake something. Actually, voice will not come when we are tensed, but still. Here, with respect to the sentence given, let's see the same sentence. She let out a quiet scream. Quiet scream is a juxtapose here. The design is composed of an irregular pattern. Pattern means itself they are following something, a sequence. And here it's written as irregular pattern. When you see with respect to hyperbole. Hyperbole is a figure of speech in which exaggeration is used. Exaggeration means saying more than what is present over there. If there are 50 chocolates with me, I will say I have more, many chocolates with me, more than 1000. Like this, exaggeration. The suitcase weighed a ton. No suitcase will weigh a ton. But still, it's exaggeration. So, it's a hyperbole. We had to wait forever for the bus. No one will wait forever for the bus. They may wait for half an hour, 1 hour. Or more than 2-3 hours. But not forever, for the whole life will they wait. So, that is the hyperbole. Oxymoron. The clown was seriously funny. Funny is something making us laugh. Seriously funny is the oxymoron over here. So this were the examples for this. Next, when you see the spelling, words ending in able and ible, they are used as suffix, you know, for the word root word. If something is kept at the starting, it's known as prefix. Few letters which they are added to the word at the last, they are known as suffix. So able and ible, permissible, ib, aud dash audible, ible, advisable, able, like this you can write the words. As you are seeing them, you can write the words. Punctuation, colon and m dash. Punctuation, colon and m dash. When you are using this, a colon you need to write a comma in between. When we see a list of things has to be taken, a list, then you have to keep a colon. Then what are the lists which we have to buy? A chart paper, a pencil, a razor, and a case like this. It goes on. M dash may come when it is necessary. Like you may, I am soaking wet. I forgot my umbrella. I capital, soaking wet, colon. I capital, forgot my umbrella, full stop. M dash may come in which place, in place within a sentence, or when it is. Dashes are informal or relaxed in conversational type. My son, where has he gone? My, M capital. Then you have exclamation and exclamatory mark. Where has he gone? Then you have a question mark. So based on the names, Vani, Kusum, you have names over here. The first letter should be capital, then you should have the comma. This is with respect to punctuation. When you see the conversation, the next part, request. Request itself is speaking some with someone in a polite way, pleasing way, courteous way, making them understand what you want to say. You should mostly use the words such as can, could, will, would, may, might. May I borrow your pen, please? Please should definitely be kept. Could I borrow your pen, please? And then, could you mind lending me your pen, please? So, agreeing a request, they may say yes, of course, you can. Declining, saying no, they will say no, I am sorry. So, these are the few examples with respect to making requests. Thank you.